well, this is a good position to be in for Nick Rabba, you know. There's some great riders in this. This is a great final. This truly is an incredible final. I mean, they always are these days. The cut is pretty tough when you get into the quarters and semis, and so it ensures that we've got a really action-packed final, some insane riding. Corey Tunison, Mike Dowdy, Tony Iacone, the last three guys off the dock. I mean, these guys are gunning head-to-head. The playing field is pretty even. I think this is probably the most even the playing field has been for years. For years you had Phil Sovin just charging it, kind of running it. Then you had Harley on the heels of that ran it, that pretty much was undefeated for quite an extended length of time, those guys back-to-back. And then now we're kind of in a stage where we were back in like the Josh Sanders King of Wake days, Eric Ruck, Sean Watson type of realm, Rathy, when there was just a couple groupings of a few years where it was a lot of fun riding, a lot of stuff happening, different names making it on the podium, and that's where we are today. First rider off the dock is Nick Rabba, one of the youngest guys in the finals. And, he's got these guys gunning for him, but he is a guy that can actually stand up to these guys' runs. I mean, he's got the skills, he's got the tricks that it needs. So you start to question, like, what's that feel like for a guy like that? How do the nerves play into that? How's the mental game play into this guy's riding right now? And, you know, the good thing about being first off the dock is that the pressure's off. Like, you got to go do your best run because the other guys probably are. So there's no real thinking. There's no mind game that can really get in the way. So the way that this is going to work, all six of these riders, they will get two runs. They get no falls. One fall and your two passes is over. You will get a second run, though. So this is the first pass of his first run. Starts off with an Indy Moby Dick. Back in on the toe side with a Pete Rose. Didn't get the kind of lift that we saw on him earlier. That one was a little bit more straight across, but super clean. Landed it nice and controlled. Back in on the toe side with a Mute Chromo 540. Nick Rabba going to have to put together a personal best here. He has not put the high score of the day up yet. There's some other guys that have had higher scores in the mid to upper 90s, and that's what he's going to need to put together on this run. Finishes his first pass with a nuclear back roll to blind. That's a great trick to have in that pass. We saw Corey Tunison put that trick in his run in the semifinal round as well. So if Nick had a fall in that first pass, the boat would have stopped, gone back to the start dock and picked up the next rider, and he would have to wait for the next five guys to go before he gets his second run and another chance to make it onto the podium. He did not have a fall. He's starting his second pass right here with a front side heel side 720. And then right here, he goes back to back toe side 900s. Now, I would think from a diversity standpoint, the one thing that might go against Nick's run is how many spins he does. Although they're highly technical and super clean, back-to-back toe side nines, and right here he went down earlier on a Mute Mode 5, but he sticks it. Oh! And he slipped out again, just like in his semifinal run. Ladies and gentlemen, let him know he can hear you. Give it up for him, Nick Rabba.
Sipping from your cup till it runneth over. Holy grail.
Blue told me remind you. Man, I wanted to see him land that. It's all good. He will get another run, two full passes, and we're going to have to see what the rest of these guys put together. Next rider on the dock, also out of Australia, the 2010 world champion. This guy's one of my favorite guys on and off the water. Known him for years, traveled the world, and he is just a charger. He is a workhorse when it comes to a competitive athlete. I mean, this guy has had his head in the game, and he just goes for it. Nobody to blame. Kirk Cobain did it to myself. And we are just entertainers. And we're stupid and contagious. No, we are just entertainers. And baby, it's amazing. I'm in-
so cold. One day you're here, one day you're there, one day you care, you're so unfair. Sipping from your cup till it runneth over. Holy
now
grail.
I got tattoos on my body, psycho beat.
All right, we got the score for Nick Rapa, 83-33. So Nick Rapa setting the pace with an 83. That's a pretty high score to start off the heat. And now that is the number to beat.
I'm getting high, sitting low, sliding by in that big body, curtains all to my window. This fame hurt, but this chain works. I think back, you act the same person. If this is all you had to deal with, you deal with this. This ain't work, this light work. Camera snapping, my eyes hurt. Dying back where I was birthed. Okay, Iris and the IRS. Get the hell up off your high horse. You got this shit to die for. Try yours. Why you mad? Take the thing with the bad and throw the baby out with that bad for it. You still alive. Still admitting. Good, you survive. Still getting bigger. Good living a lot. Vanilla wafers in the villa. Illest looking alive. Michael Jackson's Thriller.
And baby, it's amazing I'm in this space with you. I just can't. So cold. One day you're here, one day you're there, one day you care, you're so unfair. Sipping from your cup till it runneth over.
All right, Dean Smith, 9 years older than the next oldest guy in the finals. Been charging longer than any of these guys and charging harder even still today, boosting that huge indie backside 180. That to me is as hard or harder than any other trick that you'll see out here. Follows it up, technical on the toe side with a frontside 900. Back in on the heels is a stale fish back roll to blind, and he slipped out on the landing. Went higher than he... Just he kind of over-rotated the flip portion of that. Slipped out on the landing. Legends in the crowd, ladies and gentlemen. Random King of Wake champions just roaming around. Josh Sanders. So that fall will do it for Dean Smith's first run. He will get a second run. All of these guys will get a second run. A run consists of two passes, four tricks per pass. That fall, his first run basically won't even matter at this point. But it's all good. You know, the way I see it, you get to save some energy. Yeah, Dino, ladies and gentlemen of Monroe, make some noise for Dean Smith. Super psyched for this next guy. It is his first finals in the Supra PWT. I was impressed with his riding at the first stop in Texas last year when it was his rookie season on the Pro Tour, and he has continued to ride well. He's found himself into the finals today out of Australia. Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for his first finals in the Supra PWT, Parker Siegele.
Of all the things that you change, but it was just a dream.
Siegele coming in on the toe side, starting off his first run Nice. You know what? He punched through that wake a little bit, but he was able to keep his head in the game, landed high on the second wake, lands the chromo, and second trick, tantrum a blind, and again landed a little high. Pops a handle on that. Similar situation as Dean Smith. Early falls. He will get another, he will get his second run, but that's going to make that first run relatively insignificant in terms of points. So Nick Rapa currently still holding the score to beat with a score of 83. Next rider came out of the gates hot. He's out of Australia. He is a Supra team rider. He's got several victories under his belt this season. You can catch him on the cover of Wakeboarding Magazine right now. This was the year of Helm versus Harley Clifford until Harley's knee went out. And now he's got himself in a situation battling head-to-head against Mike Dowdy and Tony Iacone. Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for our next rider. Give it up for Corey Tunison. Corey's the only guy to ever land a toeside 1080 wake-to-wake in contest. He's got double flips on lock. I think he might need those today in the finals, but hey, that's his deal to make the plan that works for him. This guy's awesome. I'm excited to see him ride today. He's been charging super hard today, and it just looks effortless. Looks super smooth, super in control, and we're looking for another two passes like we saw out of him in his city final run earlier. He's in a compromising position because Mike Dowdy and Tony Iacone both get to watch him ride before they do. So they can change up their runs if they want to or need to. He is in a situation much like Nick Rapa was where, you know, he just got to go out and lay it all down. And here we go, getting it started, Corey Tunison. Nice big Butte Chromo 540. Heel side back in. Oh, he's just been doing a mute back mob right there. And so already increased the level significantly. Toe side with a 900 to 1440 with no handle. Caught the handle there on the toe side.